Well, it was quite volatile when we were there, David. We were there when the vote was announced that the first reading of these amendments, or this amendment to the Constitution granting more autonomy to regions, that this had passed. Now, it should be emphasized this is just the first amendment. There's a second amendment that will be, or sorry, a second reading that will be voted on later. But the reaction to the news of this first vote was very much negative, very passionate, the crowd shouting shame, and then they moved on to the line of the riot police there, where we saw clashes, apparently pepper spray, smoke bombs were hurled, and it was indeed it was a very tense situation while we were there. We left a little bit later. It seemed to be quieting down, in fact, and some of the crowd had left. But just 5 minutes after we left, apparently there was an explosion there. Now, a colleague from the BBC Ukrainian service was there when the explosion took place. He said he heard three smaller explosions, what could have been stun grenades or stun bombs, and then a larger one. And he saw ambulance show up, and then also the riot police, the National Guard, being taken out. He saw any number of injured, two people seriously. We've also heard from the press service of the National Guard. They say that dozens were injured and four of the National Guard are in serious condition.
Right, David, is it possible to sort of characterize who the protesters are? Do they have a particular political affiliation? Give us a bit of detail.
Well, exactly. Well, the demonstration was to a large degree led by the Svoboda, that's the Freedom Party, which is a ultra-nationalist party, but there were other groups among them. Difficult to say all the people there, there were lots of flags. It was a group of about 2,000, I would say, at its peak. They are very critical of the vote. There was also another party there known as the Radical Party, which is led by a politician by name Oleg Leshko. Now, it's not clear how much support they actually have among Ukrainian society as a whole, but they themselves are very much dead set against these amendments. They blocked the rostrum, the speaker's platform in parliament, and there were equally very passionate and volatile scenes in parliament prior to the vote. But as I said, the vote did pass with a pretty comfortable margin.